all in college, and I hope that they stay in Jessup or return after college. That's my hope. Now, to get away from the personal side, it seems like all of the testimony that I have seen allows for a power plant in Jessup. It all depends on if you feel that the zoning is exclusionary to that zone, something needs to be done. Because according to your zoning, a power plant can be built in that town. So from a personal point of view, what people feel or think means something, but from a legal point of view, you have to go by the law. That's why there's lawyers there. I don't like that the personal touch may leave, but the law is what we're talking about here. And based on the law, you have to make that determination. We've elected the council to determine whether it's exclusionary. If it is, then they need to fix that. And if it's the curative, if it's making changes to the zoning, then do it. But you can't just say, I don't want it there. You've already said, you have to have it. And that's truly what I'm trying to say. I don't want council to feel a certain way, because in Dunmore, they felt a certain way because they didn't want a methadone clinic in a certain part of town. So a number of residents got together, and so council ceded to their cares. And so Dunmore was sued by the methadone clinic, and they received $300,000. I just don't want to see us go down that path. If we do things legally, that's fine. That's what you're there for. We elected you to do that. And once you decide it, that's your determination. Tomorrow, I'll shake your hands. But if you go with the curative agreement, it seems like half of the people here won't like you forever. And that's not what this is about.
That is correct.
That's all.
That's a great idea, Bob. Thanks. Council?
Hey, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Wallace.
I'd like to start off first. This publication in the Times, and please excuse my back, was publicized. I would like to make my commitment to this as part of my official speaking here tonight. I totally agree with this, and I would like to make a part of the record, if I may. I'm an employer in this area for over 50 years. I'm not concerned whether you're union, non-union, whether you have a job or you don't have a job. This plant is temporary employment. It's good for a few jobs, build it, get it over, and that's the end of it. It's gonna have minimum amount of people. It's a computerized operation, and that's it. There ain't gonna be a lot of jobs created by it. The problem we have here is we have a bully with money. They came in here and some are, some aren't. That's why we have a democracy in this country. Before they came here, they're a huge corporation. Common sense dictates, before you buy something, find out whether or not you can even put it here. That's go to your planning, go to your zoning, go to your council, find out whether you can do it or not. Don't come in and buy something and think that you could just get away with it. That's the issue I have here. They went through the back door, should have came through the front door. That's why you have lots of people. A question of the tiles. I brought this up. I'm a pilot. I fly over here quite a bit. On an instrument approach, the towers are high. You come over to Lake Henry VOR on an instrument flight. You may very well run into one of these towers on a low flight approach, the Wolfsberry. There's an issue there. There's an issue with your cooling towers. You haven't decided whether you're going to use water, you're going to use condensation or evaporation in them. How are you going to modify them and make them work? You didn't put anything that you would not modify them at a later date once you did have them. The next system here is, you want to go here because, guess what? It's a KOZ development. You can't put a plant where it's zoned and legal in Jessup. You elected not to do it. You didn't want to modify a plant to do it. Why? Because you would have to pay taxes. Not just the grants to the people in Jessup. We don't get no benefit from your power. We don't get a darn thing from you. But if you go to the KOZ lot, you get a lot of them. You put billions in your pockets, there should be taxes in this community. That's the other thing. You know, I didn't hear anybody say anything. If you did get to build a plant where you want to build it, that the footprint would be with the plant. Planning didn't say anything about it, but the rest of the area would be green space. Then you couldn't build anything else on it. You couldn't develop anything through the back door. You're not laying the cards on the table. You have a smoke screen. There is no factuality. There's safety concerns to get to the plant. I'm a first responder. I've taken accidents that we've had on that road. That road gets blocked. There's no way in hell anybody's going to get to that plant anytime soon. If that's iced up and snowed in, you're not going to get there. And most of us know what I'm talking about. It's a rural, inaccessible area. If you have a problem or a major catastrophe, and that road is blocked.
195.
They're part-time jobs, as I said. You're not going to get anything else there. Whether your plant was built here or built elsewhere, union people are yelling, we need to have this job. Well, if you didn't build it here, you built it in Susquehanna County or Wayne County or another county, we're infringing on the rights of the people of this community, which is what you're trying to do. They can go up there and work. How many people in this room that are union employees or people that are going to work on that plant live in Jessup are going to spend their money in Jessup? Take a ride down Elder Reach and Dry Orange in Jessup here. All the buildings are vacant. The majority of them, there's nobody even working in them. So your plant isn't going to bring progress to jobs because you're selling your electric somewhere else. We don't get a discounted rate for electricity. We don't get a darn thing. And we don't even get a tax dollar. So do we think you should be here as a business man in this town, as an investor in this community? I don't think this is the place for you to be at all. Go where you can go. Go take it where you can pay the taxes or follow the rules here. Put it where it can go. Pay your fair share and stop taking advantage of the people in this community by being a bully with money. It probably costs more with attorneys tonight than what you see out of tax dollars.